So what is WardenMapper? WardenMapper is a log-based tool to help you locate specific Warden objectives in-game without getting confused and lost in the logs file itself. Essentially, WardenMapper takes the logs and outputs them in a neat text and visualizes them in a picture to help you with your speedrun. This script is considered non-game modifying and can be used in all speedruns. Disclaimer, only some features are built in, such as key and GLP locations, aka R7C1, R1B2, R1C2. Other features such as HSU location, aka R1A1, are still work in progress, as well as other maps. Since WardenMapper is a Python-based script, the first step is to install Python on your OS system. First, access your browser and go to python.org/downloads. This will be linked down in the description below. Next, you will want to download the latest version of Python, Python 3.11.1, for whatever operating system you have. Run the executable file and follow the installation prompts. Next, you can choose where your installation is or use the default path and settings. Once it has finished installing, you should be able to see the Python installation in the folder path that you selected. Next, we will want to install Python Pillow, which contains Python packages. First, navigate to a terminal or command prompt. Be sure to run it as an administrator. After the command prompt pops up, we will want to type in the following command, pip install pillow, and press enter. We should see our operating system downloading Python Pillow. If you want to update Python Pillow as notified in the installation process, we simply press keyboard keys Windows plus R to pull up the run menu and type in the following command, python.exe-m pip install --upgrade pip. This will run an update for Python Pillow. Don't worry if you didn't catch it the first time, I'll show it again here. Now, we will install Python OpenCV, another Python package. We use the same method previously shown before, but with a different command. Pip install opencv-python. All commands and written instructions will be down in the description below as well. To get and run WardenMapper, I would recommend the two following programs, Visual Studio Code and GitHub Desktop. These both will be used later in the video. Links to these pages will be down in the description below. To pull the WardenMapper program and be able to run it, you must get it first. To do that, we first navigate to our browser and go to the following link. Link will be provided down in the description below. Listed here are written instructions on installation as well. Now, press on the green code button and underneath it, press open with GitHub Desktop. This will pull the repository into your computer. From there, you can save where the code goes and brings you one step closer to running the program. To start running the program, we first navigate from the GitHub desktop to Visual Studio Code by pressing the Open Repository in your External Editor button. This will open the repository into VS Code as shown. On the landing page, we see the same README file as on GitHub. We focus now on the How to Use section, specifically line 28. Copy the command in blue, python warden-mapper.py for easy access to the command. Next, we open up a terminal instance by going to the top bar under Terminal and pressing New Terminal. A terminal should open up at the bottom where you are able to paste the command and press Enter when ready. Please note to run this specific command after you've dropped into your level. Before we get started on the demonstrations, I would like to point out that under Packages for WardenMapper, it shows the currently supported levels. Bear in mind that generated PNGs of supported levels will pop up underneath the last file in the repository when you run the command. Now, we boot up our game and select the level. When we ready up and drop, we head back to VS Code and press Enter to run our command. I recommend a dual display setup to streamline this process easier, but alt-tabbing out is perfectly fine. When we run the command, we can see where the keys are in which specific zones, areas, and lockers shown in the terminal output, as well as the generated PNG visualizing the entire log. We can open each instance of the PNGs if applicable within VS Code, and it'll mark out where exactly each Warden objective item is. Here, with R7C1, you can see how there are multiple generated PNGs corresponding to each zone where the GLPs are. You can open each of these as an instance of its own and swap back and forth between them. So that's the basis of using WardenMapper. As a recap, since it is a logs-based tool and non-game modifying, it is allowed to be used for/during speedruns. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please feel free to drop a comment down below. If you have any feedback, idea requests, or issues with WardenMapper, please use the issues link down in the description below. As always, please remember to drop a like on this video. I hope this has been an informative tutorial on how to use and install WardenMapper. See you down in the complex, prisoners, and thank you for watching.